Welcome to this beautiful A-frame cabin up in the Catskills today. This place is very modern and it has a lot of Scandinavian design elements. Stick around towards the end of this video because for the first time ever on the channel, I'm gonna be doing a mini cost breakdown on what it takes to build a cabin like this. By far, the most common comment I get on all my YouTube videos is, "Mike, what does it cost to build this Airbnb?" And I love you guys so much, but I just never have that information. You know, I have no background on construction or anything like that. But the host of this cabin actually built this A-frame using the company Den Outdoors and their A-frame house plans. I can definitely give you a very accurate cost breakdown if you stay towards the end of the video. But now let's go and start the tour of this gorgeous A-frame up here in the Catskills. Welcome to this stunning A-frame cabin located in the Catskills. The owner has dubbed this gorgeous A-frame the Charlie House. It is truly a showstopper in my opinion. Just look at this gigantic A, one of the biggest A-frames I have ever seen, and it comes in at about 1,000 square feet total. You'll also notice there on the bottom some of the stonework and the firewood underneath the deck. The cabin sits on a nice parcel of land and there are plenty of trees in front of the cabin for some added privacy. This is me, just to give you some perspective on the sheer size of this place. I mean, just look at all of these windows. It snowed the second day that I arrived here, but let's now walk up into the deck to check out the outdoor space. If we come here first, you have a nice wraparound bench, two very comfortable looking chairs and a table on one side, and another dining table, grill, and bench on the opposite end of the deck. Now to touch again more briefly on the yard, this is your view looking out from the deck, and you have this lovely fire pit setup that I used my first night here. You have string lights all throughout the yard, a big fire pit, and three chairs facing the cabin. This cabin just really pops and lights up perfectly. The owner did an incredible job with both the interior and exterior lighting, more on that later, but the Charlie House is a true beauty. Finally, before we head inside, this is what some of the beautiful surrounding area looks like. We are just a short drive away from the popular town of Saugerties, New York. But that's it for everything on the exterior. We have a lot to cover inside. So I'm gonna walk up these stairs, open up this big glass door, and it's time to check out the interior at the Charlie House. When you first walk in, you'll notice on the left that door which leads to the bathroom. On the right is the main room. This hallway takes you to the second floor, and I just walked into that room on the left through the glass door. This is the mudroom. I'm going to take off my very heavy winter jacket to get more comfortable to start the tour. We'll first hook right into this main room, which contains your dining area, kitchen, and living room. But just look at all of those windows and the large sliding glass doors. Basically, that entire wall is just glass. All of the incredible natural light is streaming in at almost all hours of the day, and it's a very open floor plan, as you can see here. One of the bedrooms is through there to the right. You can see a quick glimpse into the kitchen as well. But let me now begin to break down this room in more detail. We'll start first in the dining area. You have a large table here with enough seating for about 8 people. Also some cool decorations, bottles, trinkets, and plants on top of the table. Like I mentioned earlier, this host chose to really invest in his lighting. So if you look up top, you have this really cool modern looking lighting fixture above the table. And also in this corner, you have a few other lighting fixtures. This thin black one in particular has a remote, so you can fool around this and change the colors if perhaps you're having a fun dinner party and you're entertaining. Moving on now to the kitchen, it felt pretty minimalist to me, yet high-end at the same time. I love kitchen layouts when they just have all of the dishes, silverware, and appliances on the shelves out in the open, so I really enjoyed this layout. In terms of the appliances, on the far right you have your stovetop and your oven, and actually hidden inside one of these cabinets near the sink is your dishwasher. So I think this really cleverly concealed this appliance and still maintained the beautiful wood finishing that we see all throughout the kitchen. To now wrap up in this space, finally on the far left, also hidden behind two cabinets, you have your fridge and freezer. There is plenty of space to store all of your food if you want to do some cooking during your stay. right next to the kitchen, we'll now enter into the living room and sitting area. On the far end of the rug, we have this one chair, which is covered head to toe in fur and looks very cozy. We'll now get a bit closer. I love the overall simplistic design of this space, especially those three tables, which really match the rest of the cabin perfectly. To the left of the couch, you have some books and a lighting fixture. On the far right, you have a beautiful picture of a zebra and a bunch of goodies on top of the table. You have supplies for s'mores here. You can easily make all of that outside at the fire pit. And that picture we saw of the zebra actually transforms into a TV. Very cool. Finally, in this room, this is the view as if you were sitting on the couch. Just look at how tall these ceilings look. We're now gonna go to the right of the kitchen and walk through this door to enter into bedroom number 1 of 2. The owners spare no expense in terms of the bedding and the linens. I slept like a baby throughout my entire stay. I also ended up sleeping in this room just for that TV in the entertainment setup. You have a smart TV right at the edge of the bed, complete with surround sound. There are also a bunch of outlets there right next to the bed. Diagonal from the bed, there is another little sitting area with a small table next to it. If we walk towards the last wall, you'll notice the huge window and a shelf which is filled with more books, decorations, and lighting fixtures. To the left of all of this, right behind the bed, there is also a utility closet. The closet contains a washer and dryer unit and some cleaning supplies. Now back on the other side of the cabin, the mudroom which we entered in from is there on the left. We're gonna go through that door down the hall on the right, and this takes us into the one bathroom here inside of the Charlie house. It's pretty minimalist and modern, like that toilet there on the left. You also have plenty of shelf space above the toilet and your sink and mirror there on the right side. Opposite of all of that is your shower. It's very bright and white with all the tiling, and you have all of your shampoo, conditioner, and body soap. We'll now move further down this same hallway and enter into this work area. This is a great use of space in my opinion, especially if any of the guests need to work remotely during their stay. You have a large table though with two chairs and some other accessories which I'll get to shortly. You have a pretty serious looking surround sound system and a large speaker in the bottom left. Then on top of the table, you have a bunch of cables for all of your charging needs and some nice guest amenities like a Polaroid camera and a newly minted guest book. Last but not least, this large table that you see here is actually one of those cool standing desks. So if you just hit this button, the table can rise up as high as you need so you can improve your posture while working. That's it for everything on this floor, so we're now going to round the corner and come upstairs to the second floor, which contains the gorgeous master bedroom that you see here. I mean, just look at the size of that bed. That's about as big as they come. It's just massive. You have tables on either side of the bed as well, built straight into the wall, which is convenient, and there are a ton of pillows on top of this mattress. This is definitely a 5-star bed in my opinion. Continuing on in this bedroom, you have a nice smart TV in that corner, a little smaller than the one we saw downstairs, but still nice to watch TV from bed. You have another sitting area then in this opposite corner, definitely no shortage of seating options in this cabin. If we peek over then, you'll get a bird's eye view of the main dining and living room space, and of course all of the stunning A-frame windows which cover that entire wall. Last but not least, for some added privacy in this master bedroom, if say the kids are up but mom and dad are still sleeping, you can actually unhook these curtains right here on either side and they'll completely cover up the second floor. Okay, it is now mini cost breakdown time. All right, so I am now going to go on denoutdoors.com and today we're looking at their A-frame house plans. So I'm just going to cut to the chase. There is a ton of great info on this webpage, but I'll scroll down a bit. And this is all based on the national average per square foot. So ladies and gentlemen, the starting cost, more on that soon, the starting cost to build this beautiful, beautiful A-frame cabin comes in at about $223,000. Now, I definitely want to mention that does not cover some of the other big expenses like land, for an example. So the overall total cost is definitely, could it be more than $223,000 to be transparent?
Obviously, it also comes down to your budget, your location, and a variety of factors. This host, Nicholas, also told me that he spent a lot of extra money on things like the stonework, the thermal installation, high-end appliances, lighting. It really all comes down to what you're looking to accomplish and how much you want to invest into your property. I've actually been helping out a lot lately on the Den Outdoors YouTube channel. We recently shot a much more in-depth and detailed cost breakdown video with Nicholas, the owner of this cabin. So I'm gonna link to that video down here in the video description. Definitely go and give that a watch when you're done here. But that's gonna about do it for today, guys. Let me know what you thought down in the comments about this little mini cost breakdown session. I would definitely be open to doing more little cost breakdowns in the future if I can get that information from other Airbnb owners. Thanks so much for watching though, and I'll see you all very soon.